You came from the sky? The leader said someone would come. He delayed for so long, but he still has power. Some have lost faith. The hunters. They will have seen your star. They will not let you help him.
What are you talking about? You're not making sense.
I don't remember how to say it. He's our leader and we serve so we can go home. But some want to fight him. They were cast out. He exiled them. So they hunt his machines and those who help him. They don't believe that rescue will...
Watch out!
Hunters, they won't stop until the leader is dead.
Kill them! Agents of the Liar! He will not escape!
Incoming! We need to find someone who can make sense of this. Strip for parts. Tech's wearing out. Those hunters must be laying on the pressure. Is that a settlement? They better be friendlier than the beach group. I need answers.
Huh. They're from the same group as the ones that attacked us, but these are docile.
There aren't any men here. Maybe it affects genders differently. Makes males get violent?
Possibly, but the female on the beach said the exiled ones came back as hunters.
It doesn't matter right now. One of these people must know what my father has to do with this.
You have his face. He promised to call the sky, but he sends nothing.
He forced us to eat. To decay. You are cursed with his face.
Not the best reaction to the family resemblance, Jacob.
Why would my father force his crew to eat toxic food? Whatever's happening here needs to stop. Look at these spoiled food stores. They've been eating only that toxic local food for who knows how long. Like that wasn't obvious enough.
He has a cruel face. His cruel face. I can't talk to you. I don't want punishing.
Go away. You are like him. You will keep us here.
Shoot without question. Not exactly a long-term distance.
Well, that would make them hate him. Maybe it was just for defense. What the hell? Somebody had to push them to make that. That's borderline worship.
His face. But you fight his machines. You might stop this. I forget how to read. But this was the start. What he promised, and what they did to us. We need the sky. Take us back to the sky.
Jacob, what does it say?
It's a crew logbook. Some of them thought the beacon repair was taking too long. They were afraid they'd run out of supplies and lose their minds to the decay. My father restricted the ship food for himself and the other officers so they wouldn't be affected. Everybody else had to eat the toxic food and hope for treatment later. The rest is a casualty list. A few mutinied over the decision. My father and his officers turned the mechs on them.
It wasn't command material and it got to him. Couldn't keep the crew in line without violence.
It didn't stop there. More incidents, harsh punishments. It's like they're cattle or toys. In a year, all the male crew members are flagged as exiled or dead. They separated out the women, assigned them to officers like pets. And after the beacon is fixed, the officers appear in the casualties too. After. My father took control and didn't stop it.
Anything in there about whether the effects of the toxic food can be treated?
Nothing. But it seems like the right call. If everyone gets it, who's left to fix the beacon? You'd never get out. But they did fix it, and the signal wasn't sent until now. I'm starting to see why.
Does it say why he separated the men and the women? Or is it as bad as it seems?
No, it turns to gibberish. Maybe the men got violent early on, but from the state of this place, I'd say the Hunter thing is recent. What he allowed here, Shepard? I don't see any justification.
We haven't seen any other officers. He killed them?
There were five after the crash. Medical, engineering, bridge staff. Should have had no problem fixing the beacon and keeping people safe. All killed within the same week. About a month after the beacon was repaired.
Do you see an explanation for this? He's your father.
Is he? None of this fits. Maybe the initial decision, but the rest? Abuse of power doesn't get any clearer than this. I need to find this man. Just got free. He's covering his ass.
The old corpse was posed like a warning. The new ones were left where they fell.
The Hunters started fighting back.
Firing.
Hostiles up ahead! There we go!
Power. Oh. Excuse me. Rerouting power. Critical system damage.
Requesting assistance.
Your gun!
Change weapon.
Father in the eye and hear him justify this.
Understood.
You're here. I knew a real squad would blow through just fine. Sorry if the mech scuffed your pants. I'll get you something nice when we get back to Alliance space. I've gotta have some back pay coming.
What about your crew, acting captain?
Total loss. The toxic food turned them wild. They propped me up here in some kind of ritual behavior. Waiting for a chance to signal has been hell.
That's the best you can do?
You let all your people talk back like that? Who are you exactly?
Doesn't matter. You're running a very questionable setup here, Captain. Explain.
Of course. It was chaos after the crash, and the crew never really accepted me as captain. They rebelled and trapped us here. Once they started eating the toxic food, I couldn't control them. And I couldn't get to the beacon.
Just stop. We know what you did to your crew. Why let this go 10 years?
Who the hell are you?
Taylor. Lieutenant Jacob Taylor.
Jacob? My Jacob?
Now everyone knows everything. I want to hear you try and justify this.
You have to understand. This isn't me. The realities of command, they change you. I wasn't ready for that. I made sure you were taught right. Before I left, I hoped to leave it at that.
I'm not unreasonable, Captain, but 10 years? What happened?
God damn it! Why did you do this to your crew?
There was resistance to the plan. Mutiny. We had to take a hard line to keep order. And things settled down. As the decay set in, we made sure the crew were comfortable. Some even seemed happier. Ignorance is bliss, right? And they were grateful for guidance. Like an instinct. Pure authority was easy at first. Months in, the effect lowered inhibitions. They got territorial, rank, protocol. They couldn't understand. We had to establish dominance. After a while, the perks seemed normal.
That's it? You created a harem and played king? 10 years in a juvenile fantasy?
I can't point to where it all went wrong. But when the beacon was ready, revealing what happened didn't seem like a good idea.
What happened to the other officers?
Anders found his conscience a little late to step back. He had an accident. Things got tense. End of the day, I was the one with the mechs. I got a little basic in setting examples. But I was kind to my people once things settled down. Seemed like I'd earned some peace.
You fought over people like they were toys. Things.
The stores from the ship couldn't last forever. You had to know this would end one day.
Dining for one can really stretch things out. Besides, I can think of a lot worse retirement plans than stripping down and joining the droolers. That was before the hunters, of course. Dumb or not, I'd feel it if they got their hands on me now. They want blood. I'd prefer to keep it.
It's all about you. Everything.
You didn't feel any responsibility to get out of here for the sake of family?
I gave him a good start. He was a smart kid and was better off not following me. We figured that out a long time before I took jobs in deep space. And after things escalated here, it seemed best to just disappear off the galactic map.
Till you needed someone to save your ass.
What triggered the males to change and threaten you?
This planet has some strange cycles to it. I've seen some plants around I never saw before. Odd weather. Maybe some just adapted a little too well.
And if you treat them like animals, big shock, they become animals.
We can help these people. Cerberus can have ships here in days and pull everyone out.
He's not worth the fuel to haul him out or the air he's breathing. He's damn lucky I don't think he's even worth pulling the trigger. I don't know who you are, because you're not any father I remember.
We'll secure him for an Alliance court. For every year here, he'll have 10 to think about it.
Give him all the time in the galaxy. The man who did this doesn't know right from wrong.
I'm sorry, Jacob. I did the best I could.
I'm 10 years past believing that.
Ships are inbound to secure Captain Taylor and his crew, Commander. We'll be long gone by the time they get here.
Don't even give them the taillights.
Roger that.
What do you mean it wasn't you?
Jacob, if I had leaked the information about the gernsback, I would be smiling at your resolution of the situation. I am not smiling.
Nothing goes through this ship, my ship, without a report to you.
I had no more reason to believe Jacob's father was alive than he did. But I'm happy to know the situation is behind you.
Fine. You didn't forward it. So who did?
I did.
Was this supposed to be a favor? Or did you just want to see him squirm?
What he did with it was his own business. There was a time when it mattered to you. Sending this along seemed like keeping an old promise. I keep my promises.
Miranda, we'll discuss your liberal interpretation of security protocol in private. Shepard, Jacob.
You good with this, Jacob?
It's all bull, Shepard. Captain Taylor can rot in prison. Doesn't change who I am or what I know. I've already mourned the man he used to be. I guess he was a good enough father that even he can't screw up what he taught me.
You had no idea Miranda was behind this?
No, she's got a good memory. Selective, but good. I haven't thought about those days in a long time. Can't figure which promise she meant, though. Not sure I really want to know. She requires a better man than I.
Come on, we've got work to do.
Aye, Commander. Shepard. Thanks for the help.
Anytime, Jacob.
Shepard, how can I help?
Have you got a minute to talk?
Yes, personal matters on mind, actually. Got call from nephew. Promising geneticist himself. Just turned 16, got tenure at university. Following in my footsteps. Had to lie about what I was doing. Think he was suspicious. Doesn't matter. Still good to hear his voice.
Does anyone in your family know about what you really did for the government?
No. No, I'm lying, but won't pry. Salarians curious as a people, but also have social cues. Keep two types of secrets from family. First type, personal or guilt-based. Invite suspicion, exploration, puzzle to be solved. Reward for curiosity, intelligence, drama. Other secrets, more serious. Dangerous if discovered. Signals discourage curiosity for protection of family.
Why wouldn't everyone give clues that their secrets were too dangerous to be uncovered?
Not conscious. Social. Reflexive body language. Can't fake it. Example. Yawning perceived as contagious among humans. Subject observes yawn. Sensory input deactivates left periamygdalar region. Subject yawns in response. Social empathy. Also works with dogs. Salarian faking signals to discourage curiosity, similar to human faking a yawn. Can try, but effectiveness limited.
Are you calling him because you're worried we won't make it back?
No. Aware survival unlikely, but actually contacted him for family connection. Hard to imagine galaxy. Too many people, faceless. Statistics easy to depersonalize. Good when doing unpleasant work. For this fight, want personal connection. Can't anthropomorphize galaxy, but can think of favorite nephew. Fighting for him.
Your nephew got tenure at 16? Is he a genius or a scientific prodigy?
No, wait. Don't want to insult him. Yes, but not in manner you meant. Remember, Salarian lives short. Mature rapidly by your standards. Don't live much past 40.
I'm glad you got to talk to family before we finish this. And I'm glad we talked too, Morden.
Honored to be part of this, Shepard. Helped preserve galaxy before with genophage. Dirty work. Ethically ambiguous. Problematic. Collector's mission simpler, cleaner. We'll be proud to see it in Morden's Solus biography vid. Unless we all die. Proud posthumously, in that case, regardless. Thank you.
Thanks for diverting to the gernsback, Shepard. I appreciate being able to clean up that mess. And don't worry, it will not affect how I do my job. It's over.
I'm interested in getting to know you better.
Already? I'm not big on forcing these talks, Shepard. Let's do this later.
We'll talk later.
Commander.
How may I help you, Commander?
Do you have a moment to talk?
I always have time for you, Commander.
I better go.
Okay. Maybe we'll talk later.
Shepard.
Just checking in. How you doing?
I'm branching out. Got a list of enemies now. They all give me joy when I picture cutting them, crushing them. There's this one imprint, a Salarian with the... what are they? The things on his head pulled apart? Bet it caused a generation of revenge. What is that, a few weeks for them? So what did you want?
You know, I kind of thought connecting with your past would bring stability.
See, now we're having fun. Me remembering good deaths, and you with your funny human thing you're doing. My job is to hurt things, to direction, control. That's your job, Battlemaster. You're why I'm a soldier, not dead or crazed like an animal. Thank you, Shepard. You gave me purpose. Now let's find something big to kill.
I've got green across the board. The forward tanks are buoyant and elevated.
Are you talking about the Normandy or Miranda?
I'm talking about the one that's covered and protected, not bouncing in the breeze.
I don't know. Operative Lawson's uniform is very official. It always makes me stand at attention.
You're such a dog.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
Have you got time to talk?
I really need to clean up this engine. Maybe later?
Can you do anything to give the Normandy an edge over a collector ship?
My shield fortification will help, but I don't think there is much more I can do.
I'll let you work.
Talk to you later.
No messages for you, Commander.
Launched. Probe away. Anomaly detected. Probe away. Probe launched.
Masters didn't know what hit him. Coming around for a second patrol, looking for survival.
Probe away. Launching probe. I have found something.
Cover!
out.